Greetings everyone, my name is Ghosmuhyiddin Sayed. Me and my friend Austin Manuel have created a satellite, a LiDAR based satellite for debris detection. So before demonstrating our project, I would like to explain about debris detection, like why we have chosen this topic as our CAN satellite. Space travel is the most exciting and challenging adventure humanity has ever undertaken. But in an irony of history, we must stop ourselves from going to the space the more we do it. With every rocket launch and with every satellite deployed, we are creating a trap for ourselves that gets deadlier and more dangerous every year. Rockets are really metal cylinders that keep big parts of fuel in place. Whenever a portion of fuel has been spent, the empty tanks are dropped to make the rocket lighter. Some parts crash down to Earth or burn up in the atmosphere, but most of the useless rocket parts stay up and begin to orbit the planet. After decades of space travel, lower Earth orbit is a junkyard of spent boosters, broken satellites, and millions of pieces of junk. Right now we know around 2,600 defunct satellites, 10,000 objects bigger than a monitor, 20,000 as large as an apple, 5 lakh pieces of the size of a marble, and at least 100 million parts so small that they can't be tracked. This debris is moving at a speed of up to 30,000 kilometers per hour, circling Earth on crisscrossing orbits multiple times a day. Orbital speeds are so fast that being hit by debris the size of a pea is like being shot by a plasma gun. Now the question arises, how can we track or detect this debris? These really tiny particles cannot be tracked by a huge satellite, but a CAN satellite will be the perfect satellite for detecting debris which has a diameter smaller than a pea. So basically, we have covered the space around our planet with billions of deadly pieces of destruction, and we also put a $1 trillion global infrastructure network right in the danger zone. It performs critical duties essential to the modern world: global communication, GPS and navigation, collecting weather data, looking out for asteroids, and all manner of scientific discoveries. Things we could miss very much if they suddenly went away. If just one pea-sized bullet hits one of our 1,100 working satellites, it will be destroyed instantly. 3 or 4 satellites are already being destroyed this way every year. But the worst thing in space is not just tiny pieces of junk. The worst thing would be an unstoppable chain reaction that turns a lot of non-junk things into junk. For example, if 2 satellites hit each other in just the right way, if satellites collide, they do not stop and fall out of the sky. It's more of a splash than a crash. Orbital speeds are so fast, pieces spray right through each other, transforming 2 satellites into clouds of thousands of little things, still fast enough to destroy most satellites. This could trigger the slowest and most destructive sort of domino effect. As more and more satellites are destroyed, the destruction accelerates exponentially. So let's begin with the materials required for this project. A servo motor. A VL53L 0x sensor, a bunch of LEDs and resistors, circular solar panel, temperature and humidity sensors, a flame detector, tracking sensor, a tilt switch, a Hall effect sensor, an accelerometer, and lead acid battery, an Arduino Uno R3. So let's begin with the VL53L0x sensor, which is basic distance measuring sensor which uses an monochromatic light to measure the distance. Here we have created a visualization which basically turns red if the LiDAR detects an obstacle. This sensor will be attached onto the servo motor. So this is basically a line tracking sensor which we are going to use to detect the trajectory of a particular obstacle or debris. So for the demonstration purpose, we have coded this sensor to turn on its built-in LED when it detects the trajectory of white color. So this is a flame detector which we are using to keep where this sensor will be kept near the battery and the circuits which can catch fire to detect the fire, and we can take the protocols according to it. In addition to these, we have even added the temperature and humidity sensor to detect the temperature and humidity inside as well as outside the site. We have even added the accelerometer to measure the acceleration of the satellite. Now we have combined all the sensors at once, and this is the result in our stereo monitor. So we can see the temperature and humidity as well as the angle, the acceleration of the sensor, and we can also see the Hall effect, and we can also even see if the satellite is tilted or not.
This is Austin Manuel, and I'm here to explain the mechanism of the satellite. The materials we have used in the satellite is aluminium, as we cannot use Inconel or titanium since it is very difficult to manufacture and mine these materials. So the satellite will be containing four compartments. In the top and the bottom will contain a solar panel which will be controlled by stepper motors. There will be two stepper motors attached to each of those panels, one to open it and second to rotate it. So as the satellite will be sent into space, the solar panels will open at an angle of 90 degree, and it will be able to move 360 degrees to adjust towards the rays of towards the sun rays. The satellite will also be having two LiDARs attached inside of it. The LiDARs will be attached to a servo motor which will rotate 180 degrees. So the servo motors will be attached opposite to each other so that we can cover the whole 360 degrees. There will be an avoidance sensor in it. The avoidance sensor will be implemented in the satellite so that the satellite may avoid any projectiles coming towards it. It will avoid the projectiles coming towards it by using the thrusters at all six edges. The satellite is in the hexagonal shape, so there will be six edges, and there will be six thrusters on each of the edges. So we have a 9 volts battery, rechargeable, and this 9 volt battery is will be recharged by the solar panels. We have one here and one down, so we are using two solar panels. Meanwhile, we will be using an accelerometer for the acceleration, whereas we are using Arduino Uno as microcontroller, and here we have a tilt switch so that we can detect if the satellite is getting tilted or not.
Here we have a line tracking sensor which we are going to use to measure to detect the projectile of an object or debris. Here we have a Hall effect sensor to measure whether there is a magnetic field or not. And now here we have a temperature and humidity sensor to basically measure the temperature and humidity. And we have an ESP8266 Wi-Fi module to wirelessly get the values from it. So now we will show the complete working of this project. Now we are connecting this everything with 9 volt battery. Here we have a LiDAR attached to the servo motor, which is basically measuring the distance under 40 centimeters.